Welcome guys to Samsung Developers. I'm Kim, and you're with me today to make web apps on Tizen with ease and standards. We'll dig a bit deeper than our Hello Tizen app from last time. Starting with built-in samples and templates, we'll also make our own, configure our apps to standardize properties, and finally, packaging it once ready for release. But first, let's rewind a bit to our first app. We took you through installing the IDE, creating your first web app, and deploying it on the emulator. Now, with the current setup, let's start with the predefined samples and templates. Samples and templates serve as your guide in developing your own app. Your project may range from the four project types, namely Basic, Tizen Web UI Builder, Tizen Web UI Framework, and jQuery Mobile. Aside from the ready-made templates, you can also make your own. This saves time when creating standardized apps that have common properties. All user templates are stored in the Tizen path /IDE/user templates. And in each folder are the files that are to be copied to the new project that will use the template. Other than the contents of the project folder, there are two files included in the user template. First is the description.xml. This contains the template description information to be displayed in the project wizard. It includes the template name, version, preview, and description. The other file is the Tizen app template.xml that contains the template definition. It has the template name, widget type, description file name, and the icon image file names. There are two ways in using these templates. First is to create a new project with a project wizard and select the desired template. Other means is to copy the folder of the template, rename it as you wish, and create or edit these files as needed. Say I want to export my current project as a user template. Just go on to File, Export, Tizen, and User Template to launch the user template wizard. Now select the source project. Give it a name, browse for the desired export location, tick the checkbox if you want this template imported automatically to the project wizard, and lastly, though it's optional, provide a template description, preview image, and icon files to be shown in the project wizard. Click Next, then Finish. Application properties have to be set to fit the standards we would like to impose in our app. These are found in the config.xml file. Opening this in the IDE reveals the tabs that group the properties to make it easier to set them. After all that coding, debugging, and configuring, comes packaging the app for release. With this, you can enable a single download and installation. Web app packaging is based on the W3C packaging and configuration specification, leaving us with two build options, automatic and manual. In the automatic build option, the IDE automatically recognizes any saved changes and rebuilds the project. This is enabled by default. To change that, go to Project and Build Automatically. As for the manual build option, as the word manual implies, disable the Build Automatically option, then clean the project, and lastly, build it. Capping off the episode, here are a few points in mastering Tizen web apps. Templates, standards, configurations, and guides. You don't have to start on a blank slate. Save time and effort when things are repetitive. Configure. Whether it's changing the icon, setting privileges, and minding the orientation, these properties define the app. Now that ends our episode on advanced web apps with Tizen. We hope this tutorial helped. For inquiries, please post your questions in the official forum at developer.samsung.com. If you like this tutorial, give us a thumbs up and subscribe to the Samsung Developers channel.